I'm going to add in a label. I want this label to say description. And I'll copy, control V, make this one amount owed. Let's move the description down. And the amount owed, control C, control V, make this one notes. And the notes will come over the notes. The amount owed over the amount owed. I have to make this a little smaller so it fits. And here's the crash I was telling you about. After LibreOffice crashed, I restarted my computer to try and clear out the memory. I don't know if that helps or not, but it's something I just wanted to try. I'm going to reopen ODB 77. It's bringing up this document recovery window. I'm going to say start recovery. So it looks like it successfully recovered both things I was working on. So here's our database. When I click on reports, it looks like we should be okay. Let's edit this. So there's our report. And there is our draw document. I'm going to add in a label. I want this to have a height of 0.2. And I want this to say description. I'm going to change the font to be sans narrow. And make it bold. I'm going to copy this. Let me click on it first. Control C, Control V. I want this one to be amount owed. And I want this width, instead of 1.28, I'm going to make it 1. Now I'm going to click on this again. Control C, Control V for our third label. And this one to be notes. Now we've got the notes in there. Let's move this over and down. Let's move in the amount owed. I need to click on the selection. Move this in. Down, over. That's good. And now the description, clicking on that and using my arrows to move it around. I'm going to close my properties dialog box. In my detail, I'm selecting on my rectangles, and I'm going to move these to the top using top align to section button. With those still selected, I'm going to move in the bottom, shrink from the bottom. And the last thing we need is some labels in our footer. So I'm going to click on the label. I need to open up our properties box for that. I want this to say total amount owed, and I'm going to right justify that. And I'll make that one bold. Clicking on it so I can use my arrow keys to move this up. Now let's move this over a little bit because I need to add in a text box. And in this field, I want to make this the same as the amount owed. So the amount owed has a width of 1.2 and an X position of 3.77. So I'm going to do the same thing. Make this X position 3.77 and a width of 1.2 and a height of 0.2. I want this data to change to be function amount owed, accumulate, and then under the group invoice ID, I need to move this up. I'm selecting the rectangle in the footer because I want to shrink from the bottom to shrink that footer. The page footer, I'm selecting on that because I want to turn that off. Visible, no. One last thing, I need to click in this header section here for our group header because I want to force a new page before the section. I'm going to save this. I also want to save my database just in case something happens and it crashes. I want to be able to come back to where I'm at now. And let's run this. We've got our picture, our company name, the address, invoice. We've got the client information, the invoice number, invoice date. I might need to reposition these notes here. And also, let's make the amount owed dollar signs and right justify them. I'm going to click on the amount owed and the total amount owed. I want to change that to be a currency. And also, I'm going to right justify that from left to right. Now, this notes field, this is going to be a little trickier. How I'm going to do that is I'm going to make our detail area bigger, click on the notes field, and move that down. So it wants us to keep that within the margin. So I'm going to have to shrink this down a little bit. So instead of a width of 0.2, I'll say 1.9. Now, clicking on that, if I move it as far right as possible, it looks like it's going to be within the box a little nicer. And using my arrow keys, I'm just moving that back into place. I want to select the outside box and then shrink from the bottom. Let's save this and run it. So here we have our amount owed 50 and 35, making 85. I might want to line that up a little nicer. Our next invoice, we've got three. Our note is a little large. We can either make the font smaller or make the notes field larger, maybe take a little off our description. And then we've got our third invoice, and this one only has one task. So the 1500 for the 1500. If I shrink this down just a little bit, here we can see our two invoices side by side. And there's our completed invoice right next to the designed invoice.